Okay. So I like that you read the question in this order, because this was a nice segue, because we talked about the width all the way front to back. Here we see a panel with an integrated where the flap is stitched together. And here you see the rider. Let me just turn my camera off here so you can focus more on the picture at hand. No pun intended. Here you can see the rider, seeing how they measure the space. Ah, this gullet is too narrow. We need to make it wider in the gullet all the way front to back, or we call it spinal clearance. Now, this question was, what is important? What should it be? Always a minimum hand width, nice and wide, where the red bar is on top of the ribs, not on the spine, lumbar or shoulder blade. Okay. If you have a saddle for multiple horses, it is way easier if you start off with a nice wide channel, because if you have to have that for a round barreled horse, okay, it sits quieter, the saddle, if it doesn't roll from side to side. But if you also have a very narrow horse with a narrow spine, it is much, much easier to use another saddle pad or shimmable pads or thicker saddle pads. The second you use thicker saddle pads, it takes the space up in the gullet or in the spinal clearance. So start off with a bigger gullet front to back, because that allows you to help with different saddle pads to go from horse to horse. If it's too narrow, okay, you can't make it wider with another saddle pad. You only run into problems, spinal problems like we see all the time. So second, here you see what I talked earlier in the first question when I talked angle, okay? This is an angle device. This is an old-fashioned tool. Sometimes you use it still, okay? It measures the angle. But if you look at the pen, okay? If you look at the pen top, the green to green, that's very wide. Where my thumb is here, just by looking picture to picture, you can see if my thumb would be where the green is, this is a much wider tree width. This is a narrow tree width. The angle is very much the same. So I always recommend, if you have a saddle for multiple horses, go with the wide tree width with a medium tree angle. Again, because you can pad up. You can use multiple horses on that saddle. Definitely the single one is the metal plate, because that metal plate allows the shoulder freedom. That metal plate sits right behind the shoulder blade and BL13, okay, respiratory health. If you want to avoid any problem with your horse when it comes to, well, this is the lung meridian point. If your saddle pinches, it's too narrow, has not enough room, the horse will have problems, you know, and we all know if the heart rate is elevated, you have cortisol level in the blood that only leads to stress. And horses with stress easier get colic and ulcer. So we definitely want to make sure we have plenty of spinal clearance. That's why the metal plate in the front is really, really important. I cannot stress enough. Every saddle has a D-ring. Okay. The distance from there to there, that's your tree width. Okay. Here's the drawing again. Okay. That is your number one, what you're looking for. You could have a saddle all with medium tree width. The yellow is the distance tree width. And here the blue, the red, the green is a different angle. Here, red, 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 the same angle, but look at this. Narrow tree width, medium tree width, wide tree width. Go with a wide tree width, medium angle. Then you will avoid the dry spots. You will avoid the pinching and the biting on those sensitive area on the horse, which I showed earlier with the nerve.